Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Madhu. I'm back with yet another video with my Duke 790 aka scalpel. Today I'm going to test ride the new Benelli TRK502. I'm very much excited to ride it. Now I'm heading towards the Benelli showroom in Bengaluru. Let's see what's in the package. Guys, it's the BS6 variant and the bike looks awesome. Let's go to the showroom and see what's there in the package. There is the showroom. Oh, the bike is parked there. The TRK502 bike. The bike looks massive. My God. For 500cc engine. Look at the size of this bike. I do not know whether you are able to figure out what I'm trying to say through this super wide angle lens in this GoPro camera, but for my naked eyes, this bike looks massive. 50-ish horsepower is more than enough for touring, and we can do a bit of off-road also, I think, with this, right? Can you just give me some briefing about the specs of this bike? 47.5 horsepower with 46 Nm at 7000 rpm. What's the weight of this bike? 235 kilos. Okay, with petrol it might go up to 240, right? Guys, I was a little disappointed because the Benelli showroom did not allow me to record anything while riding. They said they are not allowing anybody to put the camera and to ride. So they have a policy, it seems they are following the policy. I said, okay man. So I came back from the test ride now. The test ride experience, my first impressions, good bike man, awesome. Somewhere down the line, I was a little skeptical. Looking at the weight of this bike, it's around 235 kilos. 235 kilos for 500cc bike. But the matter of fact is, while you're riding, you don't even feel the weight of this bike. That is how they have manufactured, the way they have designed and positioned the engine and the other parts, so that it you feel so lightweight while you're riding it. Unless and until you stop and try to turn the bike here and there, you feel that weight. But while riding, you don't even feel the weight of this bike. This is one massive 20 liter tank. And the major highlight of this bike is, this bike is loaded with accessories. You get this bike with this top box rack, saddle rack, this windshield, the aluminium knuckle guards, all this for 6.41 lakhs. That's the on-road price in Bengaluru. The price will fluctuate from state to state. I mean, man, they are giving a lot of accessories, and the price that they have quoted, 6.41, is a reasonable price, guys. If you compare this bike with Versa 650 or something, I think Versa 650 in Bengaluru on-road price is somewhere around 9 lakhs, I think. This is 6.42. It's a good deal, man. So let me talk about my first impressions after riding it. The power kicks in mid-range. The power delivery in this bike is linear. This comes with 47.5 PS, 46 Nm at around 7000 RPM. The power delivery is not aggressive, even though it's a twin cylinder. The power delivery is quite linear and progressive. I'm glad that they have given dual disc plates. Man, they have given the Pirelli Angel tire. That's the touring tire. So you get very good mileage with these tires. Mileage in the sense, not the bike petrol mileage. I'm talking about the life of the tire. And look at the seat. Seat so soft, comfortable. You can sit and ride on this seat for whole day. That's what I felt while I was riding. And all in all, it's a nice machine. And let's see what's there in the console. Let me turn on the bike. Okay, this is the RPM reading, the digital speedometer, and the trip data, the time, and the fuel range, the engine temperature, ABS, some other logos like the indicator logo, the gear logo, headlight logo. It's a basic console. It gives the basic information that is very much required for you when you're planning your long rides. It's a decent dashboard, guys. I like the dashboard. It's simple, not too complicated. While you're riding, you can just go through the details at a glance. These are all the LED lights, I think. I mean, all these are all LED lights, I think, right? Not the halogen ones. It looks beautiful, man. The design looks awesome. Very nice. Let me rev the bike a bit. Did you hear the sound? It's nice. I like the sound. Let me turn off the bike. Here you can see you can adjust the brake lever and the clutch lever. It's a massive disc plate they have given. Yes, it is very much required for this weight, 235 kilos. With full tank it will go above 240 kilos, right? And twin cylinder, as you can see the sound, man. I really do not know, I never owned any Benelli bikes, but when I rode it I felt the engine sounds refined. And the look at the parts, man. All these parts, the parts they have used, this rack, man, it looks sturdy. Fit and finish is awesome, guys, and the braking response is also quite good. And this windshield does a good job, man. And this is not adjustable windshield, and the suspension is not adjustable. That's what I heard from the sales team. This is telescopic suspension. See, let me tell you something, this bike has no electronics. It has got the ABS, electronics in the sense traction control, riding modes and all, but it's not required, guys, for this weight, right? Traction control and all is not required. This is a Holigun. This has got 9 levels of traction control, very much required for this lightweight bike. I mean, this is a naked bike I'm talking about. But when I talk about Triumph Tiger, it is loaded with a lot of electronics. Look at this tire. This is a 160 section tire, 17 inch rim. I inquired about the post-sale support of this bike. I got to know that there are 2 service centers in Bengaluru and 5 service centers in Karnataka. The post-sale support, I'm really not sure about the post-sale support. Only the owners who have been getting their bike serviced in the service centers will be in the better position to talk about it. But the basic information that I received from the sales team is the first service is 1000 or 30 days and the next service will be once in 6 months or 6000 kilometers. The service cost will be around 6 to 7000, is what the sales guy told me. My closing comments, my first impressions after riding it, though I'm not a big fan of heavy bikes, I like this bike for the performance and the package it has got to offer. When I say package, all these accessories, man, and 6.41 lakhs for this bike is worth it in my opinion. But at the end of the day, only the owner who has been riding this bike for a long time can share the ownership experience. Whatever I am talking is just my first impressions. I am not a pro bike reviewer as such. I'm just doing it out of my personal interest. I'm a bike enthusiast. I would like to ride different motorcycles. That's the reason I'm making this video as well. I've been planning for one adventure bike for some time now, so let's see how it goes.